This semester I'm teaching a seminar course on a very focused topic, question answering. As we'll see, this is important in both contemporary civilization, and this concept is also fundamental to artificial intelligence. In the coming weeks, we'll learn how computers answer questions on your phone, on game shows, and how they can fight fake news. Importantly, from my perspective, this seminar won't just be about computers answering questions. Human and computers have a lot to learn from each other, and I hope we'll be able to discover new things about these interactions. I'm really looking forward to this class because it's something that I'm passionate about, as you'll see very soon as we talk about the history of question answering in artificial intelligence. Answering questions is central not just to my research program, but also to my day job, teaching and guiding students. And it's important to me as a hobby. Even before this became a part of my research program, I was spending my weekends writing and answering questions for fun in trivia competitions. I'm hoping that this course will help you appreciate the joy and the beauty of posing and answering questions. My favorite class that I taught in a decade of being a professor was from 2012, and I ended up publishing a paper with half of the students in this class. My goal is that even though the enrollment this year is quite a bit larger than back then, is to have something like that happen again. As a corollary, this won't be exactly like other seminar courses that you might have taken. To help achieve my perhaps overly ambitious goal, this course will have the following components. Me giving people a foundation on question answering through lectures, student helping me correct my blind spots, and presenting work that they're passionate about. Working on small assignments to get introduced to the problems and data in question answering, learning how to write a research paper, and then working on an independent research project in a small group. We'll start off with the basics, making sure that everyone is familiar with the foundational concepts of natural language processing. You'll need to do a project on question answering. With every topic we'll cover, I'll also be listing some related project ideas that you could take on. We'll discuss these ideas in class, talk through what experiments you'd need to run to test it out, and generally give examples of how to create research questions and bring that into something that's publishable. To make sure that you can implement these grand research ideas, we'll have homework assignments at the start of the course to test your ability to work with models we use. However, they'll be open-ended. Try stuff out, see what works, and understand where your strengths and limitations are. I'm also hoping that some of the open-ended explorations you do on these homeworks will inspire you in your research projects. You'll also have a chance to work in different groups with other people in the class to figure out whom you'd like to work with on the final project. You'll be working on improving a model that we give you to work your way up the leaderboard. After we've built the foundation, I'm hoping to learn from you. You'll present your take on contemporary question answering research papers. We'll also discuss the choices of experiments they did in the hopes that this can help you create an even better research project. And that brings us to the big goal of the course, writing a paper that leads to a publication. Thus, we'll also spend a lot of time working on how to write a good paper. How to go from data and the ideas of your choice, carefully explaining what you're doing, why you're doing it, and making a case that your ideas worked. Because the goal is to finish the class with a strong, well-written contribution, we won't be leaving things to the last minute, like often happens in these courses. We'll be working throughout the semester, building up the paper piece by piece, from introduction to methods to related work to conclusion. And while not everyone will be able to publish a paper, I'm hoping that it will allow many of you to learn more about the art of crafting a research problem and turning it into a well-written paper, which can help you no matter what you work on in the future. So again, I'm excited about this class, But nothing will be possible without you, so thank you for being a part of this journey. I hope that it will be both informative and fun. Now that you've watched this video, be sure to watch the next videos about the logistics of the class. This is just a single lecture from a course. YouTube likes to show you these videos out of order, but if you go to the course webpage linked below, you can see the lectures in the right order, and you can get resources like homeworks or suggested reading. You can also visit quanta.org if you want to learn about our systems for creating computers that can answer questions, where Quanta stands for question answering is not a trivial activity. If you want to help the channel, provide a big gradient to the algorithm by liking and subscribing.